the idea of this transportation technology was proposed by Elon Musk some 4 years ago, and we are working towards the implementation of this technology in India. What this technology does is essentially it combines the speed of an airplane with the comfort of a train. So basically, you have train capsules that will be transporting people at speeds up to 1,000 km per hour from different places across the country.
Because of all of the sensors on the vehicle, what that means is that we get data about, say, like how your motor is functioning, how the belts are functioning on it, and this helps us provide you a more customized service, like after-sales service approach. It also helps us create things like rider profiling, which means if multiple users are using one scooter, we can customize it to each person who's using it.
Here we are using the same, using a 2D sheet. It translates into a 3D box. So it's like magic happening in front of kids. So a 2D sheet coming into form of a toy. Apart from this, we are also developing a range that is linked to CBSE curriculum. That will be out another 6 to 8 months time. So every science sector will be linked with a product like this. So when you are learning gravity, you get to know what gravity is using a toy.
When I open the door, you can clearly see that we have a full-size stretcher, we have oxygen, we have a suction machine, and we have all the equipment, and even for comfort, we have lights and fans. A medical person sits here, the patient lies down there, and the patient can be fully tended to by the medical person who's sitting out here. The AmbuPod is a 3-in-1. It's a mobile clinic, it's a telemedicine center, and it's also a micro ambulance which carries one patient and a medical person who can tend to the patient when required while the vehicle is in motion.
It's tight fit.
Yeah, it is. Is the chair going down though?
Yeah, I think it would be amazing for the rural areas. I was just in a panel where they were talking about how difficult it is to get care out there and how telemedicine can bridge a lot of that divide, but you also need certain physical components, and so having something like this to get it out to the rural areas would be wonderful.